all who gather in this home that God provides for us, to gather together as family, as we gather together in joy, in celebration, as at times we gather together in support of one another. A special welcome to any visitors who are with us this morning. My prayer for each of us as we enter into worship, whether in person or virtually, is that you may feel the presence of the Holy Spirit in a very real and personal way. Just a couple announcements before we move into our time of worship. Christmas caroling was postponed until today, so we will gather back in the gym at 3 o'clock to receive our instructions, directions from Patty and Lucky. We'll return to the gym for pizza, and then the youth will continue into having their Christmas party. So it's a full day here at the church, but a great day of joy and celebration. Circle of Friends has an angel tree, which is over in the Fellowship Center. However, I brought several of the angels over this morning. So if you are feeling God's nudge to support our Circle of Friends daycare with a gift, the table in the back of the sanctuary has several of those angels on it. Please feel free, or I encourage you to take one and to return the gift them with you next Sunday so that we may share that with that ministry. Jack Wolf has an announcement for us that he would like to share this morning.
On the back of your bulletin today, you'll notice there's a notation about the Over the Hill Gang. We are notified or talked about or said to be the Forever Young. Well, we're back after a two-year hiatus due to COVID-19, and we're doing well. And we have a luncheon this Thursday at 11:30 with a guest speaker. It's a covered dish. We will provide the meat and the entertainment, and all you have to do is show up. And you can talk to Judy Quickle, who is up here, and Linda Zodi, who is back there, or myself, because we'd like to know, get an idea as to how many will be showing up. But don't think you will be missed if you, we will miss you if you don't show up. How's that? Okay, thank you.
Oh my goodness.
Next Sunday is Christmas Eve, so I wanted to point out a revision in our worship services. We will not have Sunday school next Sunday. However, we will gather at our normal time for worship, and then please return at 6 for the children's worship service and 7:30 for the candlelight service. You'll notice in your bulletin that there's an announcement about a time of fellowship after each of those candlelight services. In order for us to have that, we need your help. Deb Duderbaugh has offered to coordinate that time, but she's in need of cookies. So unless we want Deb to be cooking through the night all week, I encourage you and invite you to please bring a tray of cookies to the church office sometime this week, so that Deb will have plenty to share and we can have a great time of fellowship between and after those services. And Jack has an announcement for us as well this morning.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
You've probably seen by now the announcement in the bulletin about the call for 50 subscribers to our YouTube channel. For a while, we've been offering Facebook Live as a live streaming service for those who cannot make it to church or anyone who gets an opportunity to watch our services. It's no longer viable. It does not allow my phone to record horizontally, and many times if we're using some type of special music, whether if it's for a special service or any of those types of offerings, that it will flag us despite the fact of having licenses to offer this type of music. So it's just not viable for us anymore as a congregation moving forward. And so with that being said, the call for 50, we're still looking for that. We only need 4. So today after church, I will be in the back to help 4 people level that they would like to be. We'll take more, of course, than 4, but we're looking for 4, then that way we can actually start live streaming these services next week. So please look for me in the back while you're eating your cookies or whatever the offering is after service, and let's get to 50. Thank you.
Today is the Sunday of joy. Whether or not you notice, one of my joys are new speakers in our sound system this week. And as I commented to a couple folks, there's no reason to fall asleep now because it's loud and clear. But please let us know if you hear of any issues as we continue to tweak and make our sound work as clearly and as well as it can possibly work. And in this day where we celebrate the joy of the light of Jesus Christ, as we prepare our hearts and minds for worship, I invite you to be in prayer of where you find joy. Sometimes it's difficult in this season that becomes so chaotic, but I invite you just to take these few moments to focus on joy and how the light of Christ brings joy into your life. Let's prepare our hearts and minds for worship together.
It's crazy how much can change on an ordinary Wednesday morning. I don't know what your job is or how important you feel. I have to admit that I don't feel like I'm called to anything special. I'm just here to get by. You keep paying me every 2 weeks, and I'll keep showing up. But it's crazy how much can change on an ordinary Wednesday morning. Because every once in a while, you get a reminder on a Wednesday morning of what's really going on here. You are really alive. God's breath is really in your lungs. And you're sitting sideways on a rotating ball in space. And when that hits you, it's no ordinary Wednesday morning. Sometimes heaven breaks through the clouds. Sometimes the hills erupt with singing. Sometimes grunt work becomes kingdom work right under your nose. Living under the banner of heaven means that the divine is near the mundane. There is no simple task, no unclean profession, no ordinary moment. And all heaven leans over the rail to see if you'll notice, if you'll look up long enough to see what's really happening. God is at work. The kingdom is here. The veil is thin. There's a party on the other side with the confetti coming through. We'll see you on Wednesday morning. It will be anything but ordinary.
Prayer for joy. This third week of Advent, let us remember that the good news of Jesus' birth has the power to bring us great joy this Christmas season. Our joy isn't dependent on what is going on in our life, in our world, or the people that we are with. It doesn't depend on the gifts that we give or the gifts under the tree. No earthly thing can ever give us complete joy. Our joy comes from you. That joy that flooded the hearts of the shepherds, the angels, the wise men, the hosts of heaven, and Mary and Joseph, is the joy that still has the power to overwhelm our hearts with rejoicing. God, you offer that same joy to us now, if we know you and recognize Jesus as our Savior and Lord. You gave us a reason to celebrate when you gave us the unspeakable gift of Jesus Christ, the light of the world. You came to dwell among us. You went to Calvary's cross for us. You overcame death and rose from the dead for us. You forgive our sins, and you give us eternal life when we believe in you. Our joy doesn't come from our jobs, our family, our relationships, our finances, or our success. Our joy doesn't come from what we have on earth or who we are with. Our joy is a gift. It is the gift that you gave us that first Christmas in Jesus Christ. Our joy is encompassed in our Savior, King Jesus. Flood our hearts with joy this Advent season as we reflect on the good news of Jesus' birth. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen.
Please stand as you're able for the call to worship. Let us go in heart and mind to see what has come to pass. Let us go with the shepherds.
Let us go to find the Savior.
Let us go with the wise ones.
Let us go to find God's promise born for us.
Let us go with the poor and humble.
Let us go to find God's promise, the light of the world, born in a lowly manger.
Let us go with all the world, with all the people of the nations.
Come, let us worship.
Come, let us adore him.
Let us enter into worship of the one who is the light of the world, bringing joy.
And now our opening prayer.
Holy God of joy, we rejoice in the realities of who you are. We live within the joy of your love for us. Our contentment comes and goes. Our happiness ebbs and flows. Our feelings depend upon our circumstances, our physical health, our brain chemistry, but our joy is deeply rooted in our identity as you are the light of our lives and love our beloved children. We give you thanks as we enter into worship.
Amen.
So,
working, Janet. So this week we're going to be talking about a nativity from Guatemala. Where is Guatemala? Central America. She was a plant. What is different about this nativity than these nativities that we've shown in the past? It's a circle. What else? How many things are all involved here? A whole bunch. They're each individual. This is all together, right? It's just little, right? And it doesn't have all the characters, but they're all in one place. Now, I did some calculations, and because this was made in Guatemala, I bought this in San Diego, California. Between Guatemala and San Diego, California, it takes 2 days and 1 hour to drive in a car. It's 2,699 miles. These are handmade, and not very many of them make it to San Diego from Guatemala. It's almost 3,000 miles. And they drive them there in the back of an old station wagon. Now, you don't know what a station wagon is. but those of us who do can cringe at the fact of driving 3,000 miles in a station wagon. It's like a van, only a really like bad version of a van. So many of these do not make it in one piece. So I was we were talking about joy today. I was very joyful that I got one in one piece. That's why I'm holding it and not letting anybody else touch it, because I don't want it to fall apart. But let me tell you a little bit real quick about what they do in Guatemala as far as how they celebrate Christmas. They decorate their homes with fresh pine needles on the floor. Okay, I can see all the mothers and grandmothers out there cringing right now because you're going to be having pine needles all over your floor. Yes. They make garlands out of fresh greens. They bring in poinsettias. They also plan and build with their entire family a nativity scene called a nacimiento, and they put it under the Christmas tree. So that's pretty cool. They use sawdust dyed in many bright colors, and I'm thinking that they probably dye the sawdust with many bright colors and then throw it, like they do in India during that festival. At midnight, they light hundreds of fireworks to celebrate the birth of Jesus. And the family has a prayer around the Christmas tree, and then they open presents after midnight. So they don't, I guess it is technically Christmas Day then. They don't wait till the next morning. They open their presents after midnight when it's Christmas Day. Next week, we're going to be talking about one from another country, and it's probably one of my favorite ones that I'm going to share. So, and that one I will hold also. So let's say our prayer again. Dear God, thank you for the many ways you give us to worship your Son. Amen.
Candle.
Oh, the candle. Oh, I forgot about that all the time. You know how we lit the candles up there? Now we have to do our own. We're not lighting them because they don't trust us with fire, me especially. So, do you want to put that over there? Do you know where to put it? Look at the arrangement of the candles up there. Perfect. That is perfect. Next week we'll complete that. That'll be fun. All right, I think you can go to do your turn.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Ted. As we move into our time of prayer this morning, I would invite you to use the Connect cards in your bulletins. If you have joys or concerns that you would like shared with your church family, I invite you to jot those on that card, to pass them to the center aisle, and the ushers will collect them and bring them forward as we prepare to enter into prayer by singing Sanctuary, and we will sing it two times. Let's prepare our hearts and minds for prayer. Lord God, we realize that we stand on holy ground in your presence. We praise you, God, for being our sanctuary. In the joys, in the sorrows, in the excitement, in the pain, in all that life throws on our journey. We praise you, Lord, for this time of Advent, a time of reflection on ourselves and our relationship with you, a time of great expectation and preparation as we once again prepare for you and for our celebration of your coming to earth as a baby in a manger. Lord, we lift to you this day those who are listed on our printed prayer concerns, those, Lord, who have been mentioned by name, and those who are on our hearts, but perhaps too deep and hurtful for us to share. We praise you, Lord, for the assurance that we have that you are already there in the work of each of those needs and each of those lives. God, in this time that sometimes becomes chaotic in the preparation, we ask that you would keep us mindful to stop and focus on the peace that you bring, the hope that you bring, and the joy that you bring. We praise you, Lord, for the joy that has surrounded this place even in these past days. As the children gathered for their Christmas pageant, as the choir practiced, and as we gather today to spread your love through Christmas caroling, and as the youth gather to celebrate the joy they have in one another through through you. And Lord, as we gather today, we are ever mindful that there are those who have not had a home, for those who, Lord, walk aimlessly in the streets searching for who they are and where home is. Lord, we are mindful for those that perhaps even in these last days have lost loved ones. We are mindful of those who their Christmas gathering will have an empty chair that once was filled. Lord, may they feel your love and your peace, and may they feel the joy of the light of you that enters into them. And God, as we focus on your coming to earth, we think about those days that you lived among us, your joyful and great entry, though lowly in a stable, the way that you walked upon the earth and showed us how to be your disciple. And Lord, in those teachings, one asked, Lord, how do we pray? And that day you taught those who stood amongst you, as you taught us, that as we gather together in your name, that together we would pray the prayer that you have given us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you.
the midst of gloom surrounding Israel, through the prophet Isaiah, God gave words of comfort and assurance of the child who came to be the light bringing joy. A reading from Isaiah. But suddenly there will be no more gloom for the land that suffered. In the past, God made the lands of Zebulun and Naphtali hang their heads in shame. But in the future, those lands will be made great. They will stretch from the road along the Mediterranean Sea to the land beyond the Jordan River and north to Galilee, the land of people who were not Israelites. Before, those people lived in darkness, but now they have seen a great light. They lived in a dark land, but a light has shined on them. God, you have caused the nation to grow and made the people happy, and they have shown their happiness to you, like the joy during harvest time, like the joy of people taking what they have won in war, like the time you defeated Midian. You have taken away their heavy load and the heavy pole from their backs, and the rod the enemy used to punish them. Every boot that marched in battle and every uniform stained with blood has been thrown into the fire. A child has been born to us. God has given us a son. He will be responsible for leading the people. His name will be Wonderful Counselor, Powerful God, Father who lives forever, Prince of Peace. In Luke's account of the birth of Christ, the angels announce the arrival of God to earth, who brings joy to everyone. From the book of Luke. That night, some shepherds were in the fields nearby watching their sheep. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them. The glory of the Lord was shining around them, and they became very frightened. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I am bringing you good news that will be a great joy to all the people." As he spoke to his followers, Jesus proclaimed that whoever believed in him would enjoy the light of the presence of God. This metaphor of light used by Jesus was common throughout Israelite history as God revealed himself through light. From the book of John. Later, Jesus talked to the people again, saying, "I am the light of the world. The person who follows me will never live in darkness, but will have the light that gives life." The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you, Carol, and thank you, Bellchoir, for that beautiful anthem this morning. Will you join me, please, in a moment of prayer? Lord God, we thank you for this time and this space. This space carved out in our lives where we come just as we are, knowing we will be accepted and loved by you and your people. Lord, may you open our eyes, our ears, our hearts, our minds to you. What you would have for each of us in these moments. Lord, may the words of my mouth, the meditation of my heart be acceptable to you. May my words serve as your vessel for your message to each of us here gathered today. Through our baby Jesus, we pray. Amen. As you have likely learned in our time together, I find great joy in this season. I've been eagerly anticipating this third Sunday of Advent, the Sunday of joy. Christmas, for most of us, is surrounded by joy. And yes, beginning to prepare for today's message, I was surrounded by the joy of the children of our daycare. The joy that is even found in the chaos of preparations, as we often spend more time with family and friends. as we purchase gifts that we know will bring great joy to others. Yes, sermon preparation in the beginning of this week began with ease and excitement as I greatly looked forward to celebrating joy. Preaching on the topic of joy was going to be a breeze. Christmas is surrounded by joy, isn't it? Then, in the midst of one of the great joys that I so looked forward to, our children's pageant, my phone rang. And it was the call that when I saw the name, and it was in the middle of the day, I knew that it was a call that was anticipated. But why now, God? Why in the midst of all the joy? Someone very dear to me, who just a few hours earlier I had prayed for Jesus to release her from her pain. He did. And she went home to be with our Lord and Savior. The pang of the reality of life hit, and it hit hard. In the midst of all the joy that was surrounding me, the laughter of the children and the excitement that they had, what I had written to share with you today no longer made sense. How I was going to preach about joy, but my heart was aching, as well as the hearts of some folks who were dear to me. In these past few days, I've reflected on the joy that I was blessed through that friendship. As I thought about the time I was blessed to spend with my friend just a day earlier, the opportunity to share the joy of a special friendship that had grown dear, to pray with her, to see her eyes widen when she realized my yes, God had given great joy, even in the midst of sadness. I've been reminded that joy is not the absence of pain, not the absence of challenges, and not the absence of difficult times, but that joy is something to be experienced in the midst of the realities that life brings. This week, I read a quote from a Hebrew scholar, J. Quinton McCain, who stated, as he referenced to the Hebrew Bible Psalms, joy is not the absence of pain and trouble. Joy is the presence of God who cares about our human hurt and who acts on behalf of the afflicted and the oppressed. What a profound statement. Though there has been joy in knowing that my friend's suffering is over and she's reunited with family who have left this earth in the past years, finding joy in the midst of pain is sometimes easier said than done, isn't it? Finding joy in the midst of pain and sorrow is found only through the light who God came to earth to be for each of us. I think you will agree that it's easy to find joy when life is going great and our prayers are being answered and it's times of great celebration and everything in life is unfolding just as we had planned. But that's not life, is it? It was in an atmosphere of pain and darkness for Israel that Isaiah wrote the life-changing words that have brought comfort and hope to a world of darkness and distress. Before, those people lived in darkness, but now they have seen a great light. They lived in a dark land, but a light has shined on them, and they have shown their happiness, their joy, like the joy during harvest time. The joy that the light of Jesus Christ brings is not just for those good and easy times. The real gift of that light, as expressed in Isaiah, is that the light shines especially in the midst of the darkness. The light shines especially in the midst of pain. And and the light who is Jesus Christ will and does always bring joy. So what is joy? It's a word that we kind of throw around easily. Google defines joy as a feeling of great happiness and pleasure. A pastor, a friend of mine, asked his church family to define joy. Here are a couple of the responses. Joy is deep. Joy is being fully present in the moment. Joy is gratitude. Joy is when we feel connected to God. We certainly feel joy in the big moments of life, don't we? In the marriages and promotions, the pride of our children when they have succeeded. But joy is experienced most often, at least for me, in the simple things in life. Seeing the pride shine on the face of our circle of friends' children as they remember their lines in the Christmas. Hearing the squeal of our children as jolly old Saint Nick entered the room, as they acted surprised, though I'm sure they weren't. Joy for us may be the smell of freshly made coffee as we begin a new day. Joy is the heart-to-heart connection with a friend. Joy may be a child wrapped around my leg in the midst of a day, that yes, he wipes his nose on my pants. It may be the warmth of the sun coming in my office window on a cold day. And it may be the fresh air as I walk outside to simply clear my mind in the midst of life. As I explore joy, I believe that it's felt in three major categories. Joy as we draw close to God and God's nature. Joy as we share the light who Isaiah foretold and Jesus affirmed as we are in community and support of one another. Joy is experience in the work of God, in our sharing our faith, in our giving, especially when our giving is inconvenient and maybe hard, and maybe even puts us in a financial strain. But often, the noise of the world keeps us from experiencing that joy for which God has intended for us. Many months as we journeyed through the pandemic, we were forced to redefine joy in many ways, weren't we? As a people person, I find great joy in our gathering on Sunday mornings. I find great joy in welcoming people into my home, particularly my children's friends. And I'm not one to believe that God causes bad things to happen. I do not believe that God pulls joy out from under us because God loves us too much. But what I do believe is that God uses those times, such as the pandemic, for us to redefine our joy, a definition that we carry into the new norm that we walk into. As we shared lockdown, we reached out more to our neighbors from a distance, didn't we? We found new ways to do ministry, some of which we've kept. We found new ways to do our jobs, and we reconnected with family who we were in a home and couldn't go out. We as well were in a darkness. In those times of darkness, if we choose to hear and believe the words of the messengers of God, fear not, for unto us a child is born. A child who brings great joy. If we choose to hear and believe, then God guides us to redefine our joy. Rather than rejoicing that God is with us, there seems to be a lot that works against us, isn't there? The noise of the world, jobs, expectations, expectations of others, sometimes expectations of ourselves, if we allow, can rob us of joy. I was reminded in these past days that it's really our choice. We can find joy. We can have the ability to receive joy, even in the darkest moments of our lives, because of the light of the baby Jesus. We have the ability to receive that joy. If we cut out the noise of the world, in the midst of challenges and pain, we can and we will have joy in the light of Jesus Christ. Some days it seems like we are surrounded by pain and grief. So we might think, is it okay for us to experience joy? So could it be that if we go about our lives living in that pure joy of the light of Jesus Christ, that others may see the light? Could it be that as we live out that joy, that others will notice and they'll want to know, where is that joy coming from? How can they experience it as well? Could it be that our joy from the light of Christ could be contagious in a world that is in so much need of joy? This week, I was reminded that there is a great connection between pain and joy. I was reminded that the real gift of light, as expressed in Isaiah, is that the light shines always, even in the midst of the dark. As the messengers of God proclaimed, do not be afraid. I bring you news of the one who is the light, the one who brings joy way down in the depths of my heart. So I ask you to consider on this third Sunday of Advent, have you accepted the joy of knowing the light who is Jesus Christ? As we come to worship each week, we come in great expectation, in the assurance that the Holy Spirit is already here waiting for us, with open arms to embrace us, no matter what kind of week we have had. We come knowing that our church family will surround us with love and support. But part of worship as well is in our giving, our time, our talents, all of ourselves. And part of that giving is in the giving of our financial means that support and allow the ministries of this church to continue. I invite you now to prayerfully give unto God your morning gifts and offerings. Lord, recognizing that the work of our hands are a gift in itself from you. We place these into your hands, Lord, praying for your guidance, for your direction, as we discern where you would lead us to use these gifts in service for you. Through the baby Jesus, we pray. Please remain standing for our closing. Empowered by the Holy Spirit.